بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ميتابوليك ريت انرجي انبوت اند اوت بوت انرجي بالانس باي بروفيسور دكتور هيام جابر سيد بروفيسور اوف ميديكال فيسيولوجي فاكولتي اوف ميديسين اسوسييتد يونيفرسيتي. اوبجكتيفز: ديسكرايب بريفلي انرجي بالانس، اندرستاند ريسبيراتوري كوشن اند اكسبلين اتس سيجنيفيكانس، اندرستاند ذا بيزل ميتابوليك ريت اند فاكتورز افكتنج ات، understand specific dynamic action of food. Metabolism is all chemical reactions and energy transformation that occur inside the body. It includes two reactions, anabolism and catabolism. Anabolism, it is the process of synthesis of carbohydrate, fat, protein and high energy rich phosphate compounds from simple molecules by processes which take up energy. Catabolism, it is the process of breaking the breakdown of fat, carbohydrate and proteins into small molecules, into small units with release or liberation of energy. Under normal conditions, 75% to 80% of this energy appears as heat. The remaining 20% to 25% is stored in the form of ATP and creatinine phosphate, which can be released and transformed into work. There are two types of work: external work and internal work. External work is mechanical work occurred during muscular exercise. Internal work includes electric work for production of resting membrane potential, osmotic work for active transport, chemical work for synthesis of various substances. Both catabolism and anabolism are in a state of continuous turnover. There are catabolism, breakdown of large molecules or substance into small units, then these units are resynthesized into large substance, and they occur in all tissues occurring including bone entities. Normally they are balanced, means anabolism equal to catabolism. So in adequate diet, the bulk of protoplasm is maintained constant. Energy is the capacity to do work. It is measured by calorie, which is the amount of heat energy necessary to raise temperature of 1 kilogram of water 1 degree centigrade. What is energy balance? Energy balance is achieved when the calories consumed, when calories intake equals to calories expended or output, so the body weight remains constant. This is energy balance. Variations of energy balance over long periods result in either positive energy balance or negative energy balance. Positive energy balance, energy intake is more than energy output. More anabolism occur, so energy stores increase, as in obese person, increase fat store, and in growing child, increase protein store. This is positive energy balance. The second variation is negative energy balance. Energy intake is less than energy output. Energy stores are catabolized more than normal, so the body weight decreases, as in the case of undernutrition and starvation. Estimation of energy intake. It is estimated by multiplying the amount of food ingested in grams multiply its physiological heat value. Physiological heat value of food is the amount of heat liberated from oxidation of food stuff inside the body. 1 gram of protein give physiological heat value equals 4.1 kilo calorie of energy. 1 gram of fat gives 9.3 kilocalories of energy. 1 gram of carbohydrate gives 4.1 kilocalorie of energy. Physical heat value of food is the amount of heat liberated from oxidation of food outside the body, not inside the body like in physiological heat value, outside the body. For carbohydrate, it is about 4.1. For fat, it is 9.3, and for protein, 5.3. Physiological and physical heat value are the same for carbohydrate and fat. This is because both substances are completely oxidized to carbon dioxide and water inside or outside the body. But in the case of protein, the physiological heat value is less than the physical heat value because it is not completely oxidized in the body and form some nitrogenous component as urea excreted in urine. Respiratory quotient. It is the ratio of the volume of carbon dioxide produced and oxygen consumed in the body during the same time. This is respiratory quotient. Significance or importance of respiratory quotient. It is an index of the substance oxidized during estimation. Means it gives an idea of what substance oxidized and used for energy released during time of measurement. If this substance is carbohydrate, RQ will be 1. This is because hydrogen and oxygen in carbohydrate molecules are present in the same ratio as water. So hydrogen oxidized with oxygen in carbohydrate molecule giving water. The remaining, the consumed oxygen is used only for oxidation of carbon to carbon dioxide. So the volume of consumed oxygen and the volume of produced carbon dioxide will be equal and RQ will be 1. If the substance is fat or protein, it will be 0.7 for fat and 0.8 for protein. This is because the molecules of these substances are poor in oxygen. So the volume of consumed oxygen will be greater than produced carbon dioxide and RQ will be less than 1. Normally RQ of the mixed diet is 0.85 and that of the brain is tissue is equal 1, indicates that carbohydrate is the only fuel used by the nervous system. Second importance of RQ is it indicates transformation of one food substance into another in the body. Carbohydrate can be transformed to fat, and in this condition RQ rise above 1. This is because carbohydrate is rich in oxygen, is transformed into fat which is poor in oxygen. The excess oxygen liberated from this conversion lessens the amount of oxygen from air used. The opposite occurs if fat transformed into carbohydrate in the process of gluconeogenesis. Third function is determination of heat value of oxygen. Heat value of oxygen is the amount of oxygen, the amount of heat in calorie produced when 1 liter of oxygen is used to oxidize different mixture of food stuff in the body. Means during metabolism, 1 liter of oxygen used to oxidize food stuff, say carbohydrate. The amount of heat liberated from this oxidation is called heat value of oxygen. This is greatly helpful in calculation of metabolic rate by indirect calorimetry. Factors affecting RQ. There are factors increase RQ and factors decrease it. Factors increase RQ above unity is transformation of carbohydrate into fat, and we discussed it before. Hyperventilation due to blowing of excess carbon dioxide. During muscular exercise, RQ may reach up to 2 in severe exercise. Metabolic acidosis and fever. Factors decrease RQ blue unity is transformation of fat into carbohydrate. During recovery period following muscular exercise, the RQ may be less than 0.5 due to increased oxygen consumption to oxidize the accumulated metabolites formed during exercise. Metabolic alkalosis, diabetes mellitus, starvation, excess RQ. It is RQ if excess metabolism that occur during the exercise period and the following recovery period. It can be calculated as follows: carbon dioxide produced during exercise and recovery minus carbon dioxide during similar period of rest multiplied by oxygen consumed during exercise and recovery minus oxygen consumed during similar period of rest. It's important if it is around unity. It indicates short exercise and the used fuel is carbohydrate. If it is blue unity, it indicates exercise for long duration and lipid used as a source of energy. Metabolic rate. It is the energy output per unit of time. It is measured by a special technique called calorimetry, using an apparatus called calorimeter, and this will be explained in the experimental book and in lab. Basal metabolic rate. It is the minimum amount of energy required by the body life at complete physical, mental rest and in burst absorptive state. Several functions of the body occurs at basal condition, like working of the heart and other organs, conduction of nerve impulse, gastrointestinal motility, ion transport across the membrane. Basal metabolic rate represent an avoidable cost of life. The standard basal conditions are physical and mental rest, in which the subject placed at bed free from any disturbances for 2 hours after a night of restful sleep, and all psychic and physical factors that cause excitement must be eliminated, must be removed, and no physical activity is performed for 2 hours before the test. Post-absorptive state. The subject must have been without eating for 12 to 14 hours. Comfortable zone of temperature means from 20 to 25 degrees centigrade when the person is dressed. Methods of determination of basal metabolic rate. By two methods, either direct calorimetry or indirect calorimetry. Direct calorimetry measures directly the actual heat released from the body per unit of time. Indirect calorimetry, in which heat produced is calculated per unit of time. Commonly, basal metabolic rate is measured by indirect calorimetry while the subject is in basal condition. The energy output is calculated per hour, then divided by the body surface area, which can be calculated from the blue chart. Importance of basal metabolic rate used for diagnosis of various pathological conditions such as thyroid function disturbance, calculation of caloric requirement for prescribing diet of adequate caloric factor and planning nutrition during diet plan during weight reduction, to know the effect of special foodstuff and drugs. Normal value of basal metabolic rate for young adult male is 40 calories per square meter per hour. Clinical expression of basal metabolic rate. It is clinically expressed as percentage of increase or decrease of from normal standard value of the subject. Means if we measure basal metabolic rate and measure it 60 calories per square meter per hour. How it is expressed? The normal is 40 calories. Thus, there is excess 20 calories above normal. This 20 calories represent 50% of 40. So it is expressed as plus 50%. The basal metabolic rate is considered normal if it is within plus or minus 14% of the standard value for his age and sex. Factors affecting basal metabolic rate. There are physiological factors and pathological factors. Physiological factors affecting basal metabolic rate. First, age. Newly born infant, it is 25 kilocalorie per square meter per hour. So, newborn are greatly susceptible to cold. At age of 20, it is 40 calorie per square meter per hour. After 20 years, the basal metabolic rate decreases at a rate of 1 calorie for each 10 years due to loss of muscle mass and its replacement with adipose tissue that has a lower rate of catabolism and a lower rate of energy release. 6. Basal metabolic rate is lower in women than men because women have less lean body mass, less muscle mass, have more percentage of fat, have a smaller body surface area. Temperature. For each rise of body temperature 1 degree centigrade, basal metabolic rate rises to 10%. Physical habits. Athletes have a higher basal metabolic rate than those having sedentary life. Training increases the bulk of active muscle and reduce fat store. Hereditary factor. Some people are born with faster metabolism and others with slower metabolism. Body surface area. Basal metabolic rate is proportion with the surface area. More surface area means that more heat loss from the body, which causes the metabolic rate to increase to maintain the body temperature. And so we express basal metabolic rate as regard surface area. Dietetic habits. High protein diet raises the basal metabolic rate by 10% more than eating carbohydrate. Sleep. Metabolic rate decreases 10 to 15% below normal during sleep. This is due to decreased muscle tone, decreased activity of the central nervous system. Climate. People living in cold regions have basal metabolic rate 10% higher than those persons living in tropical regions. This is due to adaptation of thyroid gland by secreting more thyroxine hormone in cold climate and less secretion in hot climate. Thyroxine stimulate metabolic rate and thus increase basal metabolic rate. Pregnancy and lactation and menstruation. Basal metabolic rate is more in women in those conditions اللي هو pregnant, lactation and during menstruation due to in pregnancy basal metabolic rate increase due to increased thyroid activity, additional metabolic activity of the fetus. Race affect basal metabolic rate as American and Africans have lower basal metabolic rate than European. Anxiety and tension, this they increase basal metabolic rate. Pathological factors increase basal metabolic rate and there are factors decrease basal metabolic rate. Factors increase basal metabolic rate like hyperthyroidism, which is increased secretion of thyroid hormone. This raises the basal metabolic rate up to 100%. Hyperpituitarism, increased secretion of anterior pituitary gland, can increase metabolic rate 15 to 20% as a result of stimulation of cellular metabolism. Hyperadrenalism, tumor of the suprarenal gland, raises the basal metabolic rate by 150%. This also occurs due to excessive secretion of catecholamines. Fever increase basal metabolic rate for each 1 degree centigrade rise in temperature, 10% increase basal metabolic rate. Anemia and leukemia, heart failure accompanied by dyspnea due to increased activity of respiratory muscles, diabetes insipidus, higher basal metabolic rate to maintain body temperature. Basal metabolic rate decrease in hypothyroidism, hypopituitarism, hypocorticism, hypothermia, starvation. During starvation, basal metabolic rate decreased up to 40% due to depression of sympathetic nervous system, decreased catecholamine secretion, decreased thyroxine and glucocorticoid hormone. Shock also decreased basal metabolic rate. A specific dynamic action of food, it is an obligatory increase in the metabolic rate that occurs after recent ingestion of food, or it is amount of energy released above basal metabolic rate due to processing of food. It is also called calorigenic action, thermogenic effect of food, or diet-induced thermogenesis. Facts about specific dynamic action. Specific dynamic action starts at 1 hour after food intake, reach a maximum within 4 to 5 hours, and maintained at this level for several hours. Liver is the site of a specific dynamic action of proteins because proteins fail to exert specific action after removal of the liver. But it is not the site for carbohydrate and fat specific dynamic action because the removal of the liver does not affect it. In fasting and undernutrition, specific dynamic action of all foodstuffs increase. To exhibit specific dynamic action, the body temperature must be above 33 degrees centigrade. Below this temperature, heat liberated from food become less apparent and specific dynamic action become least apparent. Specific dynamic action of protein cannot be utilized in any other way. It is a waste heat and lost, but specific action of dynamic action of fat and carbohydrate can be utilized in performance of work. For this reason, high protein diet is not suitable for heavy muscular work. Specific dynamic action of protein is useful in maintaining heat balance in cold climate. Factors affect specific dynamic action. First, type of food. Carbohydrate increase specific dynamic action by 6%, fat by 4%, protein 30%, mixed diet 10%. Amount of food, the greater the protein ingested, the more increase in metabolic rate. Environmental temperatures, excess heat produced as a result of a specific dynamic action is completely lost from the body at atmospheric temperature of 33 degrees centigrade. Causes of a specific dynamic action. A specific dynamic action is not mainly due to energy expenditure during digestion and absorption of food, as intravenous administration of food also produces specific dynamic action. It is probably due to increased sympathetic activity after food ingestion. The following causes are suggested. A specific dynamic action of protein is exerted only when proteins are breaking down, not due to protein synthesis from amino acids of food. It is due to metabolic processes that occur to amino acids in liver, particularly oxidative deamination and urea formation. A specific dynamic action of carbohydrate is due to conversion of glucose to glycogen. Specific dynamic action of fat may be also due to its storage, mobilization, oxidation, and direct stimulating effect of fatty acid on metabolic processes in the tissue. Thank you. Salaam.